Good morning, students. We will be continuing with our next lecture. So we are on that day. We have discussed what is magnetic field and what are the magnetic field lines. Now we will be starting with activity 13.3. That is on page number 224. First, we will do some reading part. Take a small compass and a bar magnet. Place the magnet on a sheet of white paper fixed on a drawing board using some adhesive material. Mark the boundary of the magnet. Place the compass near the north pole of the magnet. How does it behave? The south pole of the needle points toward the north pole of the magnet. The north pole of the compass is directed away from the north pole of the magnet. Mark the position of the two ends of the needle. Now move the needle to a new position such that its south pole occupies the position previously occupied by its north pole. In this way, proceed step by step till you reach the south pole of the magnet. Join the points marked on the paper by a smooth curve. This curve represents a field line. Repeat the above procedure and draw as many lines as you can. Now you will get a pattern shown in Fig. 13.4. These lines represent the magnetic field around the magnet. These are known as magnetic field lines. Observe the deflection in the compass needle as you move it along a field line. This deflection increases as the needle is moved towards the poles. Magnetic field is a quantity that has both direction and magnitude. The direction of the magnetic field is taken to be the direction in which the north pole of the compass needle moves inside it. Therefore, it is taken by a convention that the field lines emerge from the north pole and merge at the south pole. Inside the magnet, the direction of field lines is from south pole to the north pole. Thus, the magnetic field lines are closed curves. The relative strength of magnetic field is shown by the degree of closeness of the field lines. The field is stronger, that is, the force acting on the pole of another magnet placed is greater, whereas the field lines are crumpled. No two field lines are found to cross each other. If they did, it would mean that at the point of intersection, the compass needle would point towards two directions, which is not possible. So first we are discussing the experiment. That means how we can draw the field lines around the bar magnet. Next topic is how we can draw the field lines around the bar magnet. Suppose you place a bar magnet on a sheet of paper and place a magnetic compass near to this bar magnet. The magnetic compass has two poles. One is north pole of a compass and one is south pole of a compass. And magnet is also having two poles. One is north pole and another is south pole. What will you do? You place the compass near to the north pole of a bar magnet. That means the location of the compass, it should be near to the north pole of the bar magnet. So first point is this. What will happen? When you place this compass near to the north pole of bar magnet, the north pole of this compass, it will move away from the direction of bar magnet. But the south pole of bar magnet will move in the direction of north pole of bar magnet. What will happen? That means this compass is having the two poles, na? This is north and this is south. It will move away from the north pole of this bar magnet and this pole will move in the direction of north pole of bar magnet. Means after deflection, what will happen? Means north pole will be somewhat away and south pole will be somewhat near. You mark these positions, point A and point B, with the help of a pencil. So second concept is the north pole of the needle move away from the north pole of bar magnet and the south pole of compass will move toward the north pole of bar magnet. Means this will move away and this will move close. And again, next topic is to mark the positions. You will mark the north pole here and you will mark the south pole here. Then you will pick up the compass. After picking up the compass, you have got the two points. This is the north pole of the compass and this is the south pole of the compass. This you have marked with the help of a pencil. दैट मीन्स मार्क द पोजिशन ऑफ नॉर्थ एंड साउथ पोल ऑफ कंपस. यू आर मार्क द पोजिशन ना नॉर्थ पोल ऑफ कंपस एंड साउथ पोल ऑफ कंपस नियर टू बार मैग्नेट. देन वॉट यू विल डू, अगेन यू विल टेक द कंपस, अगेन यू विल टेक द कंपस एंड यू विल प्लेस द कंपस इन सच अ वे. सपोज दीज आर द टू पॉइंट्स दैट यू आर मार्क्ड. नाउ यू विल प्लेस द कंपस इन सच अ वे that the south pole of compass should be placed at a point where the marking of north lies. This is the marking of north na, earlier north, and this is the marking of south. Where earlier north was there, now the compass south will be present there and north will be there. Means you will move forward the compass. That means compass will be moved forward, but in such a way the south pole of the magnet collide with a point marking that is of north here. Again you will note down the positions. What will come? This is first south, this is first north. And you will get the position of this north, suppose here. Again you will place compass here, you will get another position of north here. Again you will place compass here, you will get a position of north around the bar magnet. You will repeat this procedure. That means you have placed the compass to a new position. And what is the new position? South pole of the compass is placed exactly at the mark of the north pole of compass. That means we are placing the south pole of compass at the mark of north pole. And again we are marking the deflection with points like this. We are marking with points. Repeat till you reach to the south pole of the bar magnet. Means repeat this process till you reach here. Till you reach here, you will get something like that. Yes. Connect all the marks. That means connect all the marks. You will get the field lines around the bar magnet like this. Means when you will connect all the marks, no? You will get a field line around the bar magnet. So this is a way to get the field line around the bar magnet. So this is a language we can write. Again I am repeating, means we are placing the compass near to the north, means compass we are placing near to the north pole of bar magnet. Compass is also having north pole and compass is also having south pole, but the north pole of compass will deflect away from the north pole of bar magnet, but the south pole of compass, it will deflect toward the north pole of bar magnet. Means north will get away, south will means come closer to the north pole of bar magnet. Now mark the positions we have already marked. Now place the compass to a new position. How, what is the means condition for the new position? The condition for new position be like that. This is south marking, earlier this is north marking. The compass should be placed in such a way that south occupies this location and you will get a marking of new north. Means this is second step, step number two. This is the marking obtained in step number one. Means we are placing the compass to a new position. That means how new position is there? The south pole of compass, it is exactly at the marking of north in earlier case. Again mark the deflection with the points. Repeat these concept, means same kind of concept you have to repeat until you reach the south pole of bar magnet. Connect all the marks. You will get a field line around the bar magnet like this. So you have achieved a field line. You will get such kind of field lines around the bar magnet. That means, so we will discuss the properties of these magnetic field lines. These field lines are known as the magnetic field lines. So what is the first property? They are the closed continuous curves. What is the meaning of closed? What is the meaning of continuous? What is the meaning of curve? You will get to know that. Suppose there is a bar magnet. It has two poles. One is north and one is south. You know that they are starting from the north and they are entering at the south. means outside the bar magnet, and inside they start from south and they go to north. That means it is a continuous concept and it is a closed concept. Boundary is closed, na? And it is a curve. So magnetic field lines, they are closed continuous curves. They start from the north pole of a bar magnet and they enter the south pole of a bar magnet. And inside they move from south pole of the bar magnet to the north pole of bar magnet, like this. So direction is there. What is the direction of magnetic field line? They start from the north pole of bar magnet. They go this way. They go this way. They go this way. And they go this way. They start from the north pole like this. They start and they enter the south pole. But they are continuous curves. That means they do not get destroyed here. They are continuous even inside the bar magnet. So first property, they are closed continuous curves. What is the direction of magnetic field lines? They start from the north pole of bar magnet and they enter the south pole of the bar magnet. That means their direction is from north pole of the bar magnet to the south pole of the bar magnet. That is outside direction. But inside, their direction is different. They start from the south pole of the bar magnet. Means outside, their direction is from, they start from north pole and they enter the south pole. This is the outside direction. But as they are continuous inside, they move from south pole towards north pole. So their direction is from north pole to south pole outside and from south to north pole inside magnet. So this is their direction. And you know that this is two poles of a bar magnet. Near the bar magnet, so many lines leave. This is first train, second train, third train, fourth train. Means so many trains they leave from north pole. Means crowding is there. And if the magnetic field lines are crowded at the poles, that means the strength of magnetic field is more at poles. Means crowding of magnetic field lines near the pole is more. So due to this, the magnetic field strength near the pole is also more. So near the poles, magnetic field lines are crowded. Means they are very near to each other here. But here they are not near to each other. So they are crowded here, they are not crowded here. And where they will be crowded, the strength of magnetic field lines is more at the poles. So the strength of magnetic field will be more here and less here, because less crowding is there, less magnetic field. So this is the third property of magnetic field lines. Where the magnetic field lines are crowded, strength of magnetic field will be more at that place. And inside the bar magnet, the magnetic field is uniform. Uniform magnetic field means inside bar magnet, the magnetic field lines, they are equal distance from each other. This is the concept of uniform. And their strength at this point, A point, and their strength at B point, and their strength at C point is same. Inside the bar magnet, the magnetic field lines are equal distance from each other. And strength at every point inside the bar magnet is same. So we can say that inside bar magnet, the magnetic field lines are magnetic field is uniform. So inside the bar magnet, the magnetic field line is, the magnetic field is uniform. And this is very much important concept. No two magnetic field lines cross each other. Means suppose this is first magnetic line and this is another magnetic line. They cannot cross each other because they are crossing at which point? A point, na? If we take the tangent at this point, it will give the direction of magnetic field. And if we take the tangent at this point, this is also giving the magnetic field. In the earlier direction lecture, what we have discussed, means if this is a magnetic field line, suppose we want we calculate a tangent here. What tangent is providing us the information? Tangent is providing the magnetic field direction. Means at A, the magnetic field direction will be the direction of this arrow. So one direction of magnetic field we are getting in this direction at the A, and one direction of magnetic field we are getting in this direction. So means at single point there are two directions of magnetic field. One is this direction of magnetic field and one is this direction. Means at a single point no two directions are possible, only one direction of magnetic field is possible. And if no two directions are possible, that means two magnetic field lines, they do not cross each other. Means two magnetic field lines, they can't cross each other. Why? Because at the point of crossing, suppose this, there will be two directions of magnetic field, which is not possible, because at a single point single direction of magnetic field is possible, but at a single point no two direction of magnetic field is possible. So two direction of magnetic field will not be there, which is not possible. So your today's homework is how you can draw the field lines around a bar magnet. Write a first question, and second question is write the properties of magnetic field lines. So hope you enjoyed today's lecture. Thank you. Have a nice day.